You know, he's been here. He's been very successful here. You bring in a guy like him, you know you're going to have a good to great offense every single year. And he knows these players well. Most of these players were recruited for his system. So I think he would be, the guys I've mentioned would be a great fit for Auburn. You know, and he'd have the ability to go out there and hire up a lot of assistants, I think, and, you know, possibly get a good defensive coordinator and get some guys that can really recruit. So yeah, I think he's the one that makes the most sense, but I'm certainly not saying he's a leading candidate or the guy's going to get the job.
Hey, Brian, thanks for being with us tonight. My question is on Bobby Petrino. That's a name that is on a lot of people's minds right now. And how do you think Petrino would be welcomed by most Auburn people? Do you feel like – because really, in a sense, it seems to go against what Auburn's been preaching for several years regarding family and integrity and morals, et cetera. And Petrino's got a laundry list of problems with his morals and his ethics. And,
yeah.
I mean, he just –
And I think he'd be a controversial hire, no doubt. I think there's some Auburn people who really, really want Petrino, think he's the – only guy that could win at Auburn, if you listen to what they say or post on messages on our board. But he would definitely be a controversial hire. It's not just that he cheated on his wife with a young secretary. It's that, you know, he paid for her to get a job she wasn't qualified for and then lied about it to his superiors to try to cover it up. So, you know, it's also, if you look at his last three jobs, he sort of left under very unfavorable terms. I don't think Louisville, the Falcons, or Arkansas were pleased with how Bobby Petrino left them. So, yeah, I think he certainly has some negatives, but, you know, he is a very talented coach, a guy who can, his offense can score a lot of points, and he does have that real toughness. You know, he'll have a disciplined program, and that's something that Auburn's really lacking right now.
Brian, we got Brian Matthews on the phone with us from Auburn Undercover 24/7 Sports. Brian, recruiting. Now, obviously, every time there's a coaching change anywhere and you're close to you're in the middle of recruiting season, everything's up for grabs. You're going to have guys decommit, guys say wait and see, depending on who the coach is that comes in. I know on y'all's website, you guys are keeping a list of these guys up to speed, and you're contacting those guys. What's the latest on? I know Trey Matthews decommitted today, and that was the big four-star linebacker from Georgia. I know there's several guys out there that Auburn fans are hoping they hold on to, like Reuben Foster and several other guys like D. Liner. But just tell us what else you're hearing. I know Jeremy Johnson's another one of those guys.
Yeah, well, right now just two guys have decommitted, Trey Johnson, the linebacker you mentioned, and Jaquay Williams, and you know, I think everybody else is fairly solid right now. I think most of these guys are in a wait and see type mode, where you know they're going to wait and see who Auburn hires, and some of them are still in the playoffs. They don't want to address the recruiting or the commitment until the playoffs are over. But I think the majority of these guys are going to wait and see who they hire, and then how they get along with them, how they fit along fit in his system, what assistants he hires, you know, who would be their position coaches. Those types of things before they make a decision. I think the guys who are, you know, the shakiest right now, you know, are still committed. You know, Jameer Irvin Sills, the big cornerback from Eastern Christian Academy in Delaware. He's been to West Virginia a couple times on official visits. A.J. Jackson, the tight end from Lovejoy in Georgia, is another guy who says he's committed to Auburn, then says his leaders are Florida State and Ole Miss. So that really doesn't make a lot of sense, but he's technically still committed. And you know, D-Liner is one that, you know, he wants to wait until his season's over, but certainly he's going to have a lot of options besides Auburn if he chooses to go in that direction.
Well, it's a lot of good stuff. Brian, we're up against a break, but we really appreciate you being part of the program, coming on tonight to talk about all this, and look forward to maybe having you on next week to see where this Auburn coaching search stands and then some more information on some of these recruits.
Yeah, hopefully we'll be talking about the new coach next week.
Absolutely, exactly. That's what we're hoping. Hopefully we can have you on next week, Brian. We appreciate you so much for being part of the program.
I appreciate it, guys.
Thanks so much. That's Brian.
Thanks, Matt.
Brian Matthews from Auburn Undercover. We're up against another break. We come back, a special guest will be joining you, Luke. I think people that watch our show on a regular basis know who that is already, so we won't say anything else. Stay tuned. More Sports Blitz Live presented by JR's and S&S Discount Tire right after this.